Hello all, welcome back to our channel, The Equilibrium. In the last video, we discussed about the trade-off between consumption today and saving for future. Further, we discussed about the six macroeconomic approaches given by various economists. Today, we'll talk about the first one in detail, that is John Maynard Keynes and the consumption function. We'll start with the consumption function, which is as follows. C is equal to C bar minus small c into y, where c is the consumption, c bar is the autonomous consumption. Autonomous consumption is the consumption at the zero level of income. It is considered to be constant. Hence, there is a bar over the letter c. Autonomous consumption is always greater than zero because at any level of income, we have some consumption. Next is small c, that is the marginal propensity to consume, also known as MPC, which lies between 0 and 1. We'll be discussing that in detail ahead. Next is Y, that is your disposable income, that is income minus taxes, which could either be spent on consumption or savings. For simplification, Keynes had made three assumptions. These were known as Keynes conjectures. The first conjecture is MPC is between 0 and 1. MPC is equal to the delta C upon delta Y, which is the change in consumption over the change in income. Let us consider an example. A person's initial income is 1000 rupees. At this level of income, the person spends 800 rupees on consumption. Let us suppose the income increases to 1500 rupees and consumption increases to 1200 rupees. Here, the change in income would be 1500 rupees minus 1000 rupees, that is 500 rupees, and the change in consumption would be 1200 rupees minus 800 rupees, that is 400 rupees. Hence, the marginal propensity to consume would be change in consumption over change in income, that is 400 rupees over 500 rupees, that is 0.8. Moving back to our conjecture, which is 0 less than C less than 1. For better understanding, we'll divide this equation into two parts. First is C is greater than 0, which means that MPC is greater than 0. Hence, delta C upon delta Y is greater than 0. Therefore, delta C, which is the additional consumption, is greater than 0. Second case is where C is less than 1, which means that MPC is less than 1. Hence, delta C upon delta Y is less than 1. Therefore, delta C is less than delta Y, which basically means that change in consumption will always be less than change in income. Second conjecture is average propensity to consume, that is APC, falls as income rises. APC is C over Y, that is the consumption over income. Recall the consumption function. If we divide by Y, we get APC. There is an inverse relationship between APC and income. As Y rises, C bar over Y falls, and so the average propensity to consume falls. The third conjecture is that the income is the primary determinant of consumption and the interest rate does not have an important role to play. So in short, consumption mainly depends on income. Moving on to the graph of the consumption function. On the y-axis, we take consumption, and on the x-axis, we take income. The blue line indicates the consumption function. C bar is the intercept on the y-axis. It indicates that the consumption at zero level of income, that is the autonomous consumption. MPC is the slope of the consumption function. APC is the slope of a line drawn from the origin to a point on the consumption function. So guys, this was the consumption function as stated by Keynes. Over the period of time, two anomalies, that are variations, have been observed in the Keynes consumption function. The first is the concept of secular stagnation. As suggested by Keynes, APC falls over the period of time, which basically means that as income rises, consumption decreases and savings increases. The decreased consumption and increased savings lead to inadequate demand for goods and services, as well as less profitable investment projects, which leads to a depression once in a while and is known as secular stagnation. Secular stagnation is a depression which continues until the government takes fiscal policy measures to increase the aggregate demand. The second anomaly was suggested by Simon Kuznets and led to the rise of the consumption puzzle. Simon Kuznets observed that APC was stable in the long run, in contrast to Keynes' observation of a falling APC. Kuznets discovered that the ratio of consumption to income was stable. Due to secular stagnation and finding of Kuznets, we can conclude that APC is constant in the long run. Economists wanted to analyze the reasons behind different trends of APC in short run and long run, which was presented in the form of a consumption puzzle. Now, the blue line represents the short run consumption function. As suggested by Keynes, we observe a falling APC. On the other hand, the red line represents the long run consumption function. As represented by Kuznets, we observe a constant APC. That's all for this video.
I request you all to subscribe to our channel, like, comment, and share. Stay tuned for more, and thank you so much for watching.